So, hello everybody, and this is Dr. Neha Taneja. I am your mentor and guide for PSM on an Academy platform. And today I take this opportunity, and I'm very glad to welcome between us one of our students who has cleared FMG December examination in the very first attempt. So we have with us Dr. Nandita Meni. All right. So welcome, Nandita. Dr. Nandita, how are you?
I'm good, ma'am. Thank you so much for the very warm welcome. And
My pleasure to welcome you to this platform. And how do you feel, Nandita? She has cleared her FMG students, I must tell all of you, in the very first attempt. So that's like an amazing victory for her. So let's ask her how she feels. How is she feeling right now? How are you feeling, Nandita?
of course, ma'am. Like, I feel very elated because, although I was preparing very hard, but till the time, the result doesn't come, so you still have that uncertainty in mind, like whether it'll be something good or bad. So once the result was out, like, I was, of course, I'm very, very happy right now.
Wow, that's really nice. Of course, that uncertainty, is it's always with us. And in spite of being prepared well, but I'm really happy that you cleared your FMG in the very first attempt. So, Nandita, can you tell us from where have you done your MBBS, and when did you come back to India?
Ma'am, I've actually done my MBBS from Our Lady of Fatima University, Philippines. And then, although I graduated in the month of June, but since there was a lockdown in the Philippines, so I couldn't come back. And with the documents and everything, it was a very long process. So I came back here in the last week of September. And then I started studying for FMG from October itself.
Okay, so you started your preparation from October. Like you were not your full-fledged preparation, you started from
Yes,
October.
ma'am.
Before that,
Yes, ma'am.
okay, before that, were you?
Before that, this technique that I was doing this book FMG solutions. So I used to solve like 50 questions in a day. That's it. But that like it, I wasn't very consistent with it.
Okay, all right. Okay, so basically, you started your preparation full-fledged from the month of October, right?
Yes,
So,
from October.
Nandita, how did you start your preparation? How did you divide your time? What were the platforms that you were using for your preparation? Because like only 2 months were left, right?
Yes,
So,
ma'am.
all our listeners would want to know that how did you make it possible for you to achieve this thing in a span of 2 months? How did you divide your time and everything? Can you tell us a little about that?
Yes, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. Actually, when I started preparing, although like I had a lot of notes with me, but somewhere down the line, I always had this feeling that I should go beyond the notes and maybe like I should make my concepts clear first. So I randomly one day I thought I'll search on YouTube. So I opened YouTube and then I searched for videos related to FMG. Then I found about an academy. So that's how I got to know about it. Then I watched a few videos and they were very helpful. So that's when I decided that I should subscribe to an academy. And then besides an academy, I was also using PrepLadder sometimes, but that was only for mostly question banks and then the mock tests they have. And for my preparation strategy, like I from the beginning itself, I made a proper timetable and a time schedule for everything. Like I used to study for 3 to 4 hours, then take a break for 30 minutes and then study again. And then I was also attending the live lectures on an academy. So because of that, it made me very consistent. And I feel down the line, consistency was the only reason I could clear the exam. Like had I been wasting my time somewhere in between, so I don't think I would have made it now.
Okay, that's a really a very good point that she has put out regarding consistency. And she subscribed to an academy, and she was also managing her time between watching online videos as well as preparing your content, right? So
Yes,
that is
ma'am.
very correct, very good. Can you tell us little like how had you devoted your time between reading and doing MCQs and between the tough subjects and the easier one? Like, was it like there are certain children who like keep the hard subjects, the tough subjects before and do the easier ones later? Or how did you do it? Like, had you maintained a balance between your tough subjects and your easier ones?
Yes, ma'am. Like what I did was I used to alternate. Like once I did like one, I did a hard subject, then another one would be an easier one, so that I don't feel very stressed that I'm doing all the difficult ones together, because I felt that that would make me forget things more. And then for the MCQs, what I did is like I decided that I have to finish this one particular subject in like, let's say 1 week. So after that week, I would do some MCQs and practice them afterwards. And then besides that, I always used to do revision also, because I feel if we just keep on reading and reading and then we don't revise, so it's like in any case, we'll forget that, right? So I feel revision is also very important. Like we should read maybe a little bit less, but revision should be done always.
Yes. So again, a second very good point from her that, you know, revision is an ongoing process. That's what you mean to say,
yes.
Right?
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Cannot,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, absolutely. You cannot leave your revision, you know, students for the end. If you're like she herself is saying, if she studied for 2 days, the third day should be for revision. And like she said, revision is the key. So how many MCQs on an average were you able to practice in a day? And like what target had you set that these many MCQs I'll do in a day? Did you set like this,
so,
and were you able to follow
yes,
it?
Ma'am. Like I
okay,
set a target of 100 questions per day, but like initially in the month of October, since I was studying, like I was reading a lot, so for the questions I did what maybe like around 50 questions or something in a day. But by the time November came, so in the last 15 days I was able to do 100 questions, and then like I did some mock test also on the side.
Okay, so you did do mock tests. Okay, so you know, what is it special that, how would you say Unacademy helped you in your journey? And like you attended the mock test that was put out by Unacademy right before FMG, and did you find it useful for your examination?
Yes, ma'am, it was absolutely useful. And I think because of Unacademy only, I was very consistent, because they have live classes, right? So I always had the urge to wake up early and attend the live class, because I thought if I miss it, then like I'll just leave it in the end, and I don't want to do that. So Unacademy made me very much on time for everything, for all the classes, and then for the mock test also there's time, and then they would also discuss the answers, they would also discuss MCQs in the end, and some of them actually like came out exactly like that in the exam.
Okay, that's really nice.
Yes, ma'am.
That, you know, Unacademy and all the educators on the platform were, you know, able to help you out. And
yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am, absolutely.
Okay, and like she's saying, at Unacademy, we have scheduled all our courses in such a way, the time distribution is done in such a way that, you know, you can squeeze in time for your personal
yes,
study as well. Would you
yes,
agree
ma'am.
To that fact? That, all right, okay, that's really nice, because, you know, Nandita, there is one question, you know, that bothers me as a teacher also, that nowadays content is like, so much of content is everywhere, isn't it? So as a student, did at any point of time you felt like ye chhoot gaya, or am I missing on this question bank, am I missing on this question bank, or my friends have done this, you know, are also listening from this particular place, some are listening. So, you know, how were you able to stick to one platform? Like you chose Unacademy, so how were you able to stick to it, and how did you not let other thoughts come to your mind ki, you know, wo bhi dekh lu, let me do that also, this also. So how did you manage that?
Like actually, ma'am, for that, like I always was very focused about the fact that I should not get confused, because I felt that if I'm getting confused at this point of time, I would actually not be able to do it. So even though like on various apps, like even Telegram and everything, there are so many groups, and every day they'll be posting like different quizzes, everything. But like I didn't do that, because I just stick to one platform, and then for the mock test, I had PrepLadder. So that's it. I didn't like keep a lot of focus on that.
Okay, so that is, you know, highly, another very high enriching point by her, that she was able to, you know, stick to one particular platform and accordingly. But yes, she was doing the question banks from a few other platforms. forms also. So that's really nice, and she was able to do it. So one more thing, like as the days of the exam approach, you know, your exam was on 4th of December, right?
Yes.
So like for the last 10 days, on an average, how many hours you were studying before, and in the last 10 days, did you stick to the same number of hours or did you increase the number of hours? How did you, what was your last, I would say, 7 to 10 day strategy, and how did it make a difference?
The last 7 to 10 days I devoted entirely to revision. Like I revised mostly all the subjects, not just the important ones, but the like the ones with the lesser marks also. I revised everything, and then I did like just mock tests. I didn't do simple questions at the end. And then there was this rapid revision course also that was very helpful, because in that they were all discussing just the MCQs.
Yes, that's very correct. We did do a rapid revision course for FMG students. We always do it as FMG approaches, a rapid revision kind of sessions, and we also in our plus courses. So I'm sure that must have helped you, you know.
Yes,
so
how ma'am, many that is very helpful.
Okay, that's really nice. How many hours did you study in the last 7 days?
Around eight to 10 hours, that's it.
Okay, 8 to 10 hours. Okay. And one last thing, Nandita, like how did you, whenever, see, for FMG students, it really becomes tough at times because they get these thoughts like, what happens if I don't clear? So I'm sure once or at least twice such thoughts might have come to you as well.
Yes,
so like, what made you get out of those thoughts and get back to again studying? Like if you can help our listeners with this, you know, one important thing.
Yes, ma'am. Like whenever I felt that like I might not be able to clear the exam, or I felt very stressed, I would usually like take a break. I would go for a walk, or I would meet some of my friends, and then like after some time I'll come back home, and then I'll pull myself together again, and then I'll start studying. That's what I did, because the stress, it's always there. Till the time the exam doesn't go, you still have that stress. And even after the exam, there was the stress that if I'll clear it or not, and if not, then what will be my next plan? I always had those thoughts in mind. But I think for everything, the answer is that you have to be very focused, and you just need to keep working hard.
Okay, that is very correct. You need to stay focused and keep working hard. All right, that is a lot. And one last thing again is, how did you, you know, keep away your social media distractions, the various networking that we have, Facebook, Insta, everything, how WhatsApp, how did you have any special strategy for such things? Because students really get somehow lost in those things. So how did you manage that during your, since you also had a very small time frame,
yes,
Kamta, how did you, yes, so tell us.
So I just like, I decided, I kept a tab on like how much time I'm spending on each site. So I decided, like, because Instagram is nowadays very famous, and like mostly people are on Instagram. So I decided that I'll devote only 15 minutes to it. So I set a timer. Whenever I started using the app, I would keep a timer, and then once it's already 15 minutes, so I won't use it after that. And the same I did for Facebook, but like I don't use Facebook so much. So I think it was mostly for Instagram.
Okay, all right. So that's a good suggestion, that, you know, you can put your timer on, and then you have to again stick to that timer.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
So that was great. And now that, what would you like to give some last minute tips or advice to all the listeners, to all your colleagues or friends who might be appearing for FMG this time? What are your golden words for them?
I feel like for the people who are going to give the exam maybe in June, so they still have like around 4 months with them. So I feel that even if they start preparing now, they should just be very regular. And then question solving is a very must. And then revision is the key always. And I feel that now still they still have a lot of time, so they should also like do all the subjects, not just the important subjects, because I think that's the mistake most of the people do. They just do the important ones, or the one with the more weightage, and they leave out the other subjects. But when in the exam, and it's so unpredictable, the exam is always like sometimes it's actually a mix of everything. So you cannot like leave out on one subject and devote your entire attention to another one.
Okay, so that's really good points that she's put forward for all the students who are appearing, who are going to appear for the next FMG. Like she said, that we have to be regular, we have to not leave out the smaller or the minor subjects. So you have to weigh your preparation accordingly, where you stand, be consistent, keep your notes, keep your content ready at one place, and keep on practicing MCQs, which is the key. And of course, like she's pointed out, revision. As we all keep telling you, revision, never leave it for the end. Revision is the everyday thing you have when you're talking to your friend, instead of chatting or feeling worried ki main pad paunga or will I clear or not, talk about, revise with your friends as well. So that was very nice of you to tell us these golden points. And so now that what will be your next step for NEET PG? How are you going to prepare for NEET PG after FMG you've completed? Any pointers for that as well? Will you continue? Are you attending all the classes that we're doing on an academy? And I hope
Yes,
that's
ma'am.
helping you out for NEET PG as well.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'm still preparing for NEET PG, and then like because I already have my notes from FMG, and I feel that both the exams are almost at the same difficulty level somehow.
Exactly. I completely agree. We get so many questions from students that, I cleared FMG, now how do I start for NEET PG? So like she, a topper from FMG who, appeared for the first time and cleared, she herself is emphasizing on the fact that when you're preparing for FMG, your preparation for NEET PG is also simultaneously going on. It's not like the exams are very different, or it's not like they are very, it's like one is North Pole and the other is South Pole. So you have to trust and have confidence that, you are at the same time preparing for NEET PG. All right. Thank you so much, Nandita. Thank you so much for your time, and thank you for trusting An Academy with your preparation. I mean, for your preparation and trusting it again with your preparation for NEET PG. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Nandita. Thank you.